Welcome, everyone. Here we have a time-shifted feature match between Matt Nass playing Ad Nauseam Tendrils and Alex Sittner on Shardless Bug. Huey, what do you think of the character of this matchup in general?
I think it could go either way. It's Marshall and I talked about this a bit. I think it comes down to if the Shardless Bug player is able to get... It needs a fast clock in addition to disruption. Just disruption is often not enough. But if Shardless Bug is able to, you know, get a Tarmogoyf into play and then start casting Thoughtseize and have a couple counter spells and force the Storm player, the Ad Nauseam player, to act, it makes it much, much more difficult for the Ad Nauseam player to win, because they often have to go off with more randomness. Like, they have to take a chance. If they get to the point where they know they're going to win, it's easy.
So here we have a turn one Gitaxian Probe from Matt Nass.
Sittner's hand looks pretty poor for this matchup to me. He has a Force of Will, but nothing else is... I guess he could play turn two Liliana if he draws a land.
Yeah, I was going to ask about that. Now, Liliana the Veil is a card that is pretty huge in modern mid-range decks against combo decks, like fighting against Splinter Twin, for example. Does it have the same kind of impact here in Legacy against a Storm combo deck?
Well, Splinter Twin can't kill you till turn four, right?
Mm-hmm.
And Ad Nauseam can kill you turn one, two, three. And obviously turn one is rare. Turn two is pretty rare. But turn three and turn four are not that uncommon. So I would think against... The Ad Nauseam's player's best draws, Liliana is certainly just too slow.
Right.
And against their very good draws, it's probably still a little too slow. Like, you don't really want to be tapping out around turn three. Maybe on the play it's not so bad.
So it's kind of like something that gives you a little bit of game in an otherwise kind of poor hand, a poor situation, but you're still hoping that the Storm player has a relatively slow hand.
Right. Well, the one thing that's good about it is once you have Liliana in play and you're plussing it, that's basically disruption and a threat.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean? Like, Liliana will tick up. Eventually it threatens ultimate. And also, once it's in play, even if you're not attacking for damage, you get to keep disrupting without tapping mana, which is where you want to be.
So a couple of card selection spells here from Matt Nass, just kind of setting things up. Now, if you're in Alex Sittner's seat, what are the cards you want to see coming up here?
Thoughtseize, Spell Pierce, Force of Will, Daze. He probably doesn't play Daze because it's a Shardless deck. Probably not Spell Pierce either, to be honest. Basically just cheap disruption. Him to Turek, Thoughtseize, Force of Will, like I said. Certainly not cards like Abrupt Decay, Maelstrom Pulse. You definitely want to get something like Tarmogoyf into play. Just one really fast clock.
Here's Brainstorm for Alex Sittner. Maybe looking for one of those aforementioned pieces of disruption. And here's a Tarmogoyf.
Yeah, so that's perfect. Now he wants to hope he doesn't die here, and then he can just sit on all his mana, his other disruption, and ride the Tarmogoyf to victory.
So if you're Matt Nass and you have the potential to combo off here, do you just go for it, even if it's an uncertainty? Do you feel like you're under pressure?
You might just be forced to. And now, obviously, he knows what he's up against, and naturally he'll just go for it.
Yeah, here we go. So Cabal Therapy takes out Force of Will, which Matt Nass knew was in Alex Sittner's hand.
Right, so now he can just play his... He has five mana in his mana pool. He can play Ad Nauseam, sacrifice... Or sorry, play Dark Petition, sacrifice Lion's Eye Diamond in response, get Ad Nauseam, and cast it with a mana floating plus a Volcanic Island untapped, and be in a really good position.
Yeah, that sounds like
he's already cast two rituals, a Cabal Therapy, a Lion's Eye Diamond, and a Dark Petition, so that's five spells.
So Dark Petition, looking for... It looks like he's pulled past to the past in flames to the front.
Yeah, I guess
here.
That just wins. It makes more sense than Ad Nauseam. He just gets to cast it, cast all his rituals, Dark Petition again, cast Cabal Therapy, and cast Tendrils, and it's over.
Yep, and Alex Sittner goes ahead and packs it in.
So a pretty quick game one. That's what sort of one of the powerful things about this Storm deck is. They're getting disrupted, but also they have a lot of one mana disruption of their own, considering it's a combo deck. But the fact that like Duress and Cabal Therapy both cost one mana and count as a spell for your Storm count make it very easy to fire off a bunch of those.
So we're going to go ahead and jump forward to game two. We can skip past all the sideboarding and shuffling. Looks like turn one, Alex Sittner leading off with a Thoughtseize on the play.
Matt Nass with a Sylvan Library in his Storm deck.
That's pretty interesting. Yeah.
Looks like he has two copies in his sideboard. I haven't seen that before, although it's possible I just missed it.
Yeah, it makes some sense when you're up against a slower deck that has a lot of disruption.
Yeah.
Like the combination of an opponent who can disrupt you early, so you need the card advantage going long, but also can't necessarily clock you that quickly. Sylvan Library is kind of the perfect card in that situation. So Brainstorm the choice with Thoughtseize. Matt Nass with just one land. Looks like he picked up a Gitaxian Probe off the top.
Yeah, so Matt's probably thinking about whether or not he wants to cast the Probe here. The downside is if he doesn't and he gets Thoughtseized again, he might actually lose the Probe and his chance to find a second land to play Sylvan Library. The upside is he just gets a little bit more information if he waits a turn. He could also draw into something like Ponder and cast it, of course.
Yeah. Does pick up a second land in Tropical Island.
So he probably wants to play the Delta to protect himself from Wasteland, yeah.
And down comes Tarmogoyf for Alex Sittner.
Tarmogoyf already a 2-3.
So interesting choice I see here for Matt Nass coming up. Now, assuming he draws something irrelevant, would you play the second land and try to just play Sylvan Library knowing your opponent has Force of Will?
Yes.
Just to get the Force of Will out of their hand?
Yeah, I mean, you got to get Force of Will out of their hand, and he has a clock. It is tough because Sylvan Library is an enchantment in the graveyard for Tarmogoyf.
But
still, I mean, what are you going to do? Just sit around? Like, it's not like Matt doesn't have a whole lot going on.
Yeah, it's a good use of your mana, I mean, on a turn where you otherwise don't have a lot to do, so you might as well proactively force your opponent to use the Force of Will now
and
have more freedom on future turns.
Sylvan Library is not that threatening if you think you're going to be able to race it with Tarmogoyf.
Yeah, that's fair, and it looks like Alex declines to Force of Will. It's also possible he didn't have a second blue card. I didn't see for sure. And down comes Liliana of the Veil, ticking up. So this is really like kind of the perfect start you were talking about earlier. Turn one hand disruption into a potent threat, fast clock, and Tarmogoyf into more disruption from Liliana
of
the Veil.
I think this also, with Alex having two cards, I mean, one is a Force Will, but this definitely has the downside of what I was talking about. You're tapped out. Matt knows that at best you can counter one of my spells. If he's able to sculpt a hand there that can cast a Duress and then go off, or cast a Therapy then go off, he knows he's going to win the game.
Yeah, that's true. And he does have the potential to pay up to 8 life for up to 2 extra cards here, too.
And he does pay the 8 life.
Oh, wow. I like this.
And I think he might have it.
Let's check it out. Triple Lotus. Okay, leads off with the Duress. I see a bunch of mana in Matt's hand.
Yeah, and once he casts the Duress and it resolved, I think he said, I have you. That's Duress, Petal, Lion's Eye Diamond, Ritual, Infernal Tutor, Past in Flames, Ritual, Tendrils. Yeah, it's over.
Wow. Amazing. That's it.